As we commemorate the lasting legacy of September the 11th, there's been understandably a great deal of attention paid to the attacks on the World Trade Center and the Pentagon, but less so for Flight 93, the United Airlines flight on which passengers and crew fought back against the terrorists and thwarted their plans. It's believed the U.S. Capitol was the intended target for that hijacked plane, but instead, because of their intervention, the plane went down in a field in rural Pennsylvania. That site has become an important touchstone for the family and friends of those who died. William Brangham is back now with a conversation about that memorial and the story of those who perished.
The Flight 93 Memorial in Somerset County, Pennsylvania, is dedicated to the 40 passengers and crew members who brought down that flight and averted potentially a much worse disaster. There's one part of the memorial that the general public can visit, but there are also many acres that are considered sacred ground where parts of the plane came down. Throughout the past two decades, Gordon Felt has been the president of Families of Flight 93. His brother Edward was on that plane. He was a 41-year-old engineer with two daughters when he died. And Gordon Felt joins me now. Gordon, thank you very much for being here. I know this is obviously a very difficult time. And this anniversary is certainly something that has captured the nation's attention. And I just wonder how that sits with you and other family members at this time, at this milestone.
Well, once again, the eyes of the world are back on Flight 93, the World Trade Center, and the Pentagon. It's an opportunity for us to look back over 20 years, reflect on our losses, reflect on the ripple effect of September 11th, how it continues to create loss and create great strife for us. But it's also a unique opportunity for us to reach out to a new generation of students and even young teachers to help tell the story of Flight 93, about the heroism, about the sacrifice, the honor that was demonstrated by our loved ones that morning.
I was struck recently by the service members and women who died in Afghanistan as they were that few weeks ago leaving Afghanistan, and how many of them were babies or just toddlers when 9/11 originally happened. Do you think that we have done a good enough job of remembrance, of remembering what happened on that day and what has happened since?
I think it's critical that we have to actively remember. It's far too easy to move on, to forget our losses, forget the lessons that we learn. So there's no question September 11th was an extraordinarily difficult day in our nation's history, with the loss of thousands of innocent people. And since then, the continued loss of thousands upon thousands of our military service men and women. And it's you know, we can't afford to just move on, you know, now that we're out of Afghanistan, just kind of let's look for the next issue to focus on.
Can you tell me a little bit about your brother, Ed?
Ed was a gentle, caring genius, no doubt about it. He loved his family deeply, more than anything. He loved learning. He loved mentoring. He loved meeting people. He loved solving problems. He was a computer engineer that traveled the world problem solving for his company. Ed was a lead engineer in one of the teams that helped establish the protocols for early internet financial transactions. We never really understood what he did. He tried to explain it to us, but he was operating at a far higher plane than most mortals. But I do know that Ed always had time for anyone, certainly for his children, his family, the people he worked with. He would give you the shirt off his back, and he is missed greatly. I mean, he was the patriarch of our family. He was the one you could always call. He was unflappable. Again, a problem solver. He would talk through issues. He would until they were solved, and that's who he was.
A problem solver and a mentor, certainly the kinds of people we need more of. I know that you and many others fought very hard for this memorial to come to fruition. For people who visit that memorial, what do you hope that they take away from that visit?
Well, there's a couple important aspects that we want people to take away as they drive out of the Flight 93 National Memorial. First, when they're here, we want them to learn the story, the facts of the day, to learn about the individual people, you know, those 40 heroes that were on board that got up that morning. You know, on the morning of September 11th, my brother got up and had breakfast with his eldest daughter. They read the Wall Street Journal. That was their habit. And then he got in a, you know, car service to go to Newark Airport, and we never saw him again. And, you know, of all the thousands of people that died that day had similar stories. They just were going about their business. We want visitors that come to this memorial to realize that it could have been any one of us that day. It didn't make a difference how old you were, how young you were, what your profession was, you know, what the demographics were. That didn't make a difference. And by remembering the individuals, by saying their names, by learning about those individuals, that makes it personal. We can relate to that. And then after the personal side, in saying the names and in remembering those individuals, it's critical that we also remember what they did collectively. The passengers and crew members of Flight 93 had 35 minutes. 9:28 was when the hijacking began. 10:03 was when the plane came down here in Somerset County, Pennsylvania. In those 35 minutes, they were able to get information from the ground, to understand what was going on, to realize that their plane was also going to be used as a missile, that unless they did something, those terrorists were going to dictate the terms on how their lives ended. Under that extraordinary pressure, they were able to actually come up with a plan on how to try to take the plane back. They voted on that plan. They prayed together, and then they acted. They fought to retake that plane. And while we know they lost their lives, in the process, they did something extraordinary. The passengers and crew members of United 93 revealed true heroism that morning, and for that we need to remember and honor them.
Right, the day after that awful event, we all remember that sense of national cohesion that we all felt, and maybe it's naive in some way to think that that could have sustained for two decades, but do you see us more divided? Do you see us more cohesive?
Oh, there's no question we're more divided. I long for September 12th. It is possible. We have it in us. We've demonstrated that we are able to function together, respectfully, communicate, problem solve. We've strayed a long way from where we were that day. And I think that we have to work diligently to try to get back on track as a nation so that we can once again be one people working to do good, working to do what's right.
All right, Gordon Feltz, president of Families of Flight 93, thank you so much for your time. And we all hope that this week of commemoration is as gentle as possible for you all. Thank you.
Thank you.